raunchy, violent, not suitable for those below 18. But that doesn't mean these video games should be banned altogether. This was probably what the board of film censors thought when they banned the game Mass Effect last year, then reversed that ban and gave it an interim M18 rating instead.
The present system, because it's a PG-rated system, there are some games that are not allowed, mainly because of the guidelines. But if you notice, we introduced an M18 interim rating system since November 07, and since November till now, we've actually classified 8 M18 games. So that gives you an idea that there'll be a lot more choice for gamers out there once we introduce the rating system.
The classification system will have two ratings, M18 and Age Advisory. Under M18, games with realistic depictions of violence like Cain and Lynch or strong sexual content like in Mass Effect can be sold only to those 18 years old and above. Games that have moderate levels of violence, nudity and some coarse language will be rated Age Advisory and restricted to those 16 and older. Other games in the market not labelled M18 or Age Advisory are approved for general consumption. In line with the Board of Film Censors' practice of co-regulating with the industry, companies are required to declare all games meant for local distribution and sale via an online questionnaire. Companies will be required to submit physical copies of the titles only when the game contains mature content. The new system is also aimed at giving parents more control over what their kids play.
Those viewers who aren't familiar with the parental controls that are embedded in the Xbox, it essentially allows parents to use the existing rating system to control the games that their children play. Now that Singapore has introduced a rating system, we can start looking at how we can incorporate that into Xboxes in Singapore so that parents can have better control over what their children are playing on Xboxes in Singapore. That will come in the next year or so, but it does depend on what MDA ultimately finalizes their rating system on.
The new system will start on the 28th of April and the board will review it after 6 months to see how the industry and consumers are reacting to the new rules. Game wholesalers and retailers may also be licensed in future so as to ensure that they do not sell mature games to underage buyers. As for selling unclassified games, while retailers could be fined up to $40,000 and jailed up to 6 months.
To help the public understand the video games ratings, MDA is organizing a series of outreach initiatives targeting at gamers, parents, teachers and retailers. Members of the public can also get more information about the classification system from this website from the 28th of April. Ng Kai Ling, The Straits Times.